Hello, my name is Cornelius Kölbel, and today I want to show you how you can use the privacyIDEA credential provider to secure the login to your Windows desktops. Here we have a Windows network with your Active Directory and several Windows clients, some Windows 10 machines and a Windows 2019 server. We will install privacyIDEA on these machines and add a second factor to the authentication. First, we will need a privacyIDEA machine in the network, and the privacyIDEA machine will read users from the existing Active Directory. And on the privacyIDEA machine, we can assign tokens to the users. We can assign a key fob token, we can assign a YubiKey. We will also assign a push token so that you can authenticate with push notification. And maybe we will be able to talk shortly about offline authentication. To secure the login on the Windows machine, we need to install the privacyIDEA credential provider on each machine which we want to secure. These credential providers will communicate with privacyIDEA and verify the second factor. Great. So now let's get started.
Okay. I have a couple of machines. I have a domain controller. I have a Windows 2019 server and I have a Windows 10 client. I have a privacyIDEA system which reads the users from Active Directory, and I will enroll a YubiKey for the administrator so that the administrator is able to log in with this YubiKey to the Windows 2019 server. And I will enroll a push token for a normal user so that the user can log in with the push token to the Windows client. So let's take a look at privacyIDEA. I configured the privacyIDEA server to read users from our lab environment. And currently I have no tokens enrolled. So to enroll the YubiKey, I have to do the following. Here I have my privacyIDEA admin client and I will talk to the privacyIDEA server as the administrator super and start the YubiKey mass enrollment. The YubiKey is inserted, it is initialized, and the YubiKey is enrolled. I could now plug in new YubiKeys and enroll further YubiKeys, but the one YubiKey is totally sufficient for me. When I now take a look at my privacyIDEA system, I can see, great, here my YubiKey, my newly enrolled YubiKey has appeared, and I can assign the YubiKey to my administrator. Assign. Now I will assign a push token to a user, to a normal user, Cornelius. The push token uses the privacyIDEA Authenticator smartphone app. A challenge is sent to the smartphone and the user can confirm that he wants to log in. So let's see, I fetch my user and I enroll a new token to the user. I choose a push token and say enroll. And now I have to take my privacyIDEA Authenticator smartphone app, and it's exchanging asymmetric key pairs now. The smartphone app is working and it communicates with the privacyIDEA server, and here you see it automatically told me that the token has been enrolled. I now have two tokens in the system. One token, one push token for the user Cornelius, and a YubiKey for the administrator. I will set an authentication policy here. Wait a second. To authentication policy. Okay, let's put it here. I want to do the following. OTP pin. I want to, as the OTP pin, I want to use the Active Directory password. So I can set the policy to use the password from the user store. And this is important so that I can actually, for example, trigger the push token, since it's a challenge response token. So the credential provider will tell privacyIDEA that the user Cornelius wants to log in by sending the Active Directory password to privacyIDEA, and this will trigger the challenge. Okay, we've done everything on privacyIDEA side. Now we can move to the Windows systems where the credential provider is installed, configure the credential provider, and log in. Here I am on the Windows 2019 machine. I've downloaded the credential provider, and I will now install the credential provider so that the administrator will have to log in with the YubiKey from now on. I'm starting the installer. I will make the privacyIDEA credential provider the default provider, which means there's no other credential provider available. You shouldn't do this in the first step. Okay, well, maybe we will leave this alone, because you shouldn't do this in the first step, because then no other provider will be available, and this way you could lock you out if you misconfigure the system. So now we have to tell where the privacyIDEA server is located. You should have a decent SSL certificate. Well, I will ignore it for now. And in my case, I want to have the OTP login field in the second step. And as I configured the OTP pin to be the taken from the user store, I will send the domain password to privacyIDEA. Okay. Here I could use a custom logo. I will go for the default, with the default for now. The credential provider is installed, and now when I wait a second, we can have a look at the registry. I'm sorry, that's a German installation, but I think you will get the idea. Here in the registry, under HKey local machine software NetNights, you will find all the privacyIDEA credential provider settings. You can also change these settings later. Here I have my host name where the privacyIDEA server is located, and my two-step settings. Okay, now we will see what happens. Okay, I have to connect again to my Windows machine. And here you now can see my login at the Windows 2019 server. You see, I could still log in with my normal credential provider with my credentials, since I allowed several credential providers to be used. Later, you would deactivate the other credential providers. But for now, let's go this way. Okay. Now the domain administrator is supposed to log in. Sorry, I have to change the keyboard. NetNights Lab Administrator. In the first step, the administrator will provide his domain password. It will be sent to privacyIDEA. It will be checked successfully, and then I will be asked to add my second factor, the YubiKey. Sorry, it tells you, please enter your second factor. And now I will take my YubiKey. I simply press the button and bam. Okay, you need a demo subscription to run the credential provider. You can get it at GitHub privacyIDEA, privacyIDEA credential provider. Go to releases. This is also the place where you get the latest MSI package. Here's the subscription package. I will download it somewhere. And now I need to import the subscription to my privacyIDEA server. Okay, I go to components, go to subscriptions, and say upload file. I will do this in private because you are probably not really interested in the contents of my hard drive. Or, well, I am not interested that you know the contents of my hard drive. Anyways, I imported the subscription, and now, great, I will be able to log into my Windows 2019 server, hopefully. Okay, NetNights Lab, go for the administrator. As mentioned, in the first step, we provide the domain password of the administrator. We now try to talk to privacyIDEA. It works out. And now I simply push the button and the administrator is logged in. And this way you can secure the login to the Windows machine using the additional second factor of, for example, in this case, the YubiKey. Unfortunately, I have some network issues with my Windows 10 client, so I will again use my Windows 2019 server here to log in as user Cornelius and use my smartphone with push notification as a second factor. In the first step, I provide the Windows password and privacyIDEA sends a notification to my smartphone. I accept this and I am logged in.
Thank you for your interest in securing your Windows desktops with a second factor using privacyIDEA. The great thing is that once you have installed privacyIDEA in your network, you can use it at a lot of other locations. For example, securing your firewall or VPN and also connecting it to privacyIDEA. This way, users can use the very same token to authenticate against the VPN.
Check out our other videos in the video description. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Bye.